Yes. Good afternoon, students. So today we will discuss the main questions which we have left in the previous class. So in the previous class, we have completed 27 questions. Now we will discuss the another one, next question, that is called as some of the characteristics of BT cotton are. Some of the characteristics of BT cotton are high yield and resistance to boll worms, long fibers and resistance to aphids, medium yield, long fibers and resistance to beetle pest. Okay, high yield and production of toxic protein crystals which kill diphtheria pest. So among these four, so which one is the correct one? So here this fourth one is the correct one, high yield and production of toxic protein, because we have inserted the BT gene into the cotton plants. We have inserted the BT gene into the cotton plant. Okay, as it is inserted to the cotton plant, in the cotton plant, this BT gene will produce the protein. This BT gene will produce the protein, and that protein will kill the insect. Okay, because of this one, it is the correct. Okay, the first one is also correct, but how it will be? Resistance to boll worm, that is not given here. High yield and resistance to boll worm. But how it is? Because of toxic protein crystals. That statement is not there. So this is the correct one. So that this is the fourth one is the correct one. High yield and production of toxic protein crystals which kills the diphtheria. The next one, what is true about BT toxin? What is true about BT toxin? BT proteins exist as active toxin in the bacillus. Okay, in the bacillus it will produce in inactive form. It will be synthesized into inactive form. Okay, so this inactive form will not harm the bacteria. Okay, so this is wrong. The activated toxin enter the ovaries of the pest to sterilize it and thus prevent its multiplication. The activated toxin means the protoxin will activated in midgut of the insect, but not the ovaries. So this is wrong. Okay. Next one. The concerned bacillus has antitoxins. Okay. So this bacillus does not have the antitoxins because in the bacillus, that protein will be synthesized in the inactive form. Okay, the inactive protoxin gets converted into active form in the insect gut, that is mid gut, in the digestive system. This is the correct statement, because in the insect gut, mid gut, what happens? pH is alkaline. In the what? insect get pH is alkaline. Because of that reason, this protoxin will convert it into active toxin or active molecules. So the fourth one is the correct one. Next question. Bacillus thuringiensis, BT strain, have been used for designing novel. Bacillus thuringiensis, BT strains have been used for designing novel. Okay, it will be used as a biofertilizer, biometallurgical technique, biomineralization process, bioinsecticidal process. This BT gene or the Bacillus thuringiensis strain will be used as in bioinsecticidal process to the plant. Means the insect will be naturally killed. How it will be killed? By the toxin which are present in the organism. So that toxin will kill the what? Insect. So it is bioinsecticidal plant. So this strain, Bacillus thuringiensis, the BT gene will be inserted into the plant for the bioinsecticidal process. Okay, so this is the correct one. So biofertilizer means, so that may be the other organism which enrich the soil nutrient. That is called as biofertilizers. So here the correct one is bioinsecticidal plants. The next question. Okay, how is BT toxin known to kill the target insect in protection of cotton plant? How is BT toxin known to kill the target insect in the protection of cotton plants? Okay, the first option is mitigate cell lysis and swelling, paralysis and loss of coordination, formation of abnormal proteins, brain death. Okay, when the BT or the protoxin will enter into the midgut, so what happens? The toxin will be activated. This activated toxin will make a hole. The activated toxin will make a hole in the epithelial cells. Okay, here the hole will be prepared. So through this hole, what happens? The fluid will be enter into the hole. As this fluid will be entered into the hole, what happens to the epithelial cells in the midgut? Epithelial cells in the midgut will be swells and get lysis. Okay, the epithelial cell will get swelling and get lysis. How it is? By making the hole or pore into the what? Epithelial cell. So the option one is correct. In the midgut cell lysis and swelling will be takes place, because in the midgut the alkaline alkaline pH is present. If that alkaline pH, the crystal protein will be activated. The crystal protein will be activated. So the correct answer is 1. The next, crystals of BT toxin produced by some bacteria do not kill the bacteria themselves because, okay, crystals of BT toxin produced by some bacteria do not kill the bacteria themselves because the first option is bacteria are resistant to the BT toxin. Toxin is immature. Toxin is inactive. Bacteria enclosed toxin in a special sac. Okay. Bacteria enclosed in a special sac. So among these, what happens? In the bacteria, the toxin is inactive. The toxin is inactive. Okay, because of this inactive nature, what happens? It will not cause any harm to the bacteria. Okay, when this toxin, which is inactive, will enter into the insect midgut, it will be activated. As it is activated, what happens? That will cause a what? Holes and lysis of the what? Epithelial cells, and that will kill the insect. So the correct one is toxin is inactive. The next question. BT brinjal is an example of transgenic crop. BT brinjal is an example of transgenic crops. In this, BT refers to, okay, so BC refers to, BT refers to Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay, Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay, this is the correct one. Okay, Bacillus tuberculosis, that is an bacteria which cause the TB. By technology, it is a process for the manipulation. It is a process for the manipulation of the organism. Beta carotene, it is a precursor. Precursor of vitamin A. Okay, means for the biosynthesis of vitamin A, the beta carotene is required. Okay, for the synthesis of vitamin A, beta carotene is required. So here the correct answer is Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay, the next one. Next one. All the following statements are correct for BT toxin, but one is wrong. Which one is wrong? BT toxin is produced by bacteria called Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay, this statement is correct. BT toxin is produced by bacteria called Bacillus thuringiensis. The next, BT toxin or protein toxins like thuriocytes and sporionin, which are active against different group of insect. So this is also correct. It is harmful to the thuriocytes and sporanin, which are active against a different group of insect. This also correct. The BT toxin is harmful for man. Here, BT toxin is not harmful for man. So this statement is wrong. Okay, and this is the correct answer. BT toxin is harmful for men. So this statement is wrong because BT toxin is not harmful for the man. The next statement, upon ingestion by susceptible insect, the BT protoxin is converted into the BT protoxin is converted into active form and kills the insect. Okay, so it is a crystal form will be converted into soluble form. Soluble form. Okay, and this soluble form will kill the insect. Okay, so here the statement 3 is correct one. The next one, golden rice is a transgenic crop of the future with the following improved traits. Golden rice is a transgenic crop of the future with the following improved traits. Insect resistance. So this golden rice is not an insect resistance. Okay, it does not consist lysine as an essential amino acid. It is also wrong. High protein content. This is also wrong because this golden rice consists, or it is the what crop will be developed for the high protein content. So how it will get the high protein content? Because in the golden rice, what happens? It consists beta carotene gene. This beta carotene gene is a precursor for the biosynthesis of vitamin A. It is biosynthesis of vitamin A, and this vitamin A will reduce or will be given for the treatment of night blindness. This vitamin A will be given for the treatment of night blindness because this vitamin A grains or in the golden rice grains consist beta carotene, so that will synthesize the vitamin A. By consuming this golden rice, what happens? Night blindness will be cured. By consuming this golden rice, night blindness will be cured. Okay, that the correct answer is high vitamin A content. Next, next question. Consider the following statements A to D about organic farming. So here this question is regarding with the organic based agriculture. Okay, utilize genetically modified crops like BT cotton. Okay, utilize genetically modified crops like BT cotton uses only naturally produced inputs like compost, does not use pesticides and urea, produce vegetables rich in vitamins and minerals. Which of the above statements are correct? Okay, utilize genetically modified crop like BT cotton. So this BT cotton is a genetically modified or genetically based agriculture. Genetically based agriculture. So this statement is wrong. Next, uses only naturally produced inputs like compost. So compost means the manure. Okay, so this is called as organic manure. So this organic manure will be produced by the what? By the dead remains of what organism? Particularly here what happens, that is cow dung, or you can say that dung, urine of the animal. The next, the twig of plant, leaf. Okay, all these will be dumped in one place. All these will be dumped in one place. As it is dumped in one place, what happens, that will undergo the decomposition process. After this decomposition, what happens, it will produce the organic manure. Okay, so this organic manure is called as compost, and it is used in the organic farming. So this statement is correct. Next, does not use insecticides and urea. Okay, so here, so in this one, does not use of insecticides and urea. So this is also correct, because what happens, as they are using, as they are growing, what happens, the plant is having the resistance in the plants. In that condition, what happens, they are using the to kill the insect or the pest by the application of the bio molecules or the bio medicine, like the leaf of neem plant. Okay, the leaf of neem plant will be dried and mixed and sprayed to the plant. Okay, so that will be used the bio insecticide and pesticide. So by this one, what happens, the use of insecticide will be, does not takes place, and instead of this urea, they are using the compost. This second and third statement is correct. Okay, so this is the correct one. Okay, the next one, cry protein is obtained from Bacillus thuringiensis, Bacillus subtilis, Clostridium welchi, E. coli. Okay, the cry protein will be obtained from thuringiensis, that is the BT gene. So this BT gene will produce the protein. That protein is called as cry protein. Okay, that protein is called as cry protein, and this cry protein will be obtained from Bacillus thuringiensis. So this is the correct one. Next, gene amplification using primers can be done by gene amplification using primers can be done by microinjection, ELISA, polymerase chain reaction, gene gun. Okay, amplification means increase in the amount of gene, means double the amount of DNA, that is called as gene. Double the amount of DNA, that is called as gene. Okay, so this doubling the amount of DNA or gene will be takes place by the polymerase chain reaction. It is a PCR technique. Okay, so by this one, the amount will be what? Increased. The microinjection, it is the process to deliver the isolated gene into animal host cell. Microinjection is the method to deliver the isolated gene or DNA into the animal host cell. This gene gun, or it is called as bioelastic. What happens? This gene gun, using this one, that is bombarded with gold or tungsten. That is golden tungsten. So then it is what happens? The gene will be inserted into plant cell, because in the plant cell, cell wall is present that will not allow by the micro injection. So this is the gene gun. ELISA means it is a one of the procedure to detect, is a test to detect the HIV, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, or AIDS will be detected. Okay, so this is the ELISA. So the correct one is polymerase chain reaction. The correct one is polymerase chain reaction. Okay. Next, which one is a true statements regarding DNA polymerase used in PCR? Which one is true statements regarding DNA polymerase used in PCR? Okay. It is used to ligate, introduce DNA into the recipient cell. Ligation means ligation fusion. So for this one, PCR is used. So here, for the ligation or the ligate, the PCR is not used. For the ligation of the ligate, the PCR is not used. It serves as selectable marker. Okay, so here the PCR will not be used for the selectable marker. Okay, so this polymerase will not be used, because for the selectable marker, what happens? Antibiotics resistance gene. Antibiotic resistance genes will be used. Okay, then isolated from the virus. So this DNA polymerase will not be isolated from the virus, which are used in PCR. Okay, then so this, it remains active at high temperature. So this DNA polymerase will be remains active at high temperature, that is 72 degrees Celsius. So this DNA polymerase will be used during primer extension. this DNA polymerase will be used during the primer extension. Okay, so this statement is correct. What is that? It remains active at high temperature. The next question. A bioreactor refers to, fermenter refers to a device in which substance are treated to stimulate biochemical transformation by living cells. A device in which substance are treated to stimulate biochemical transformation by living cells. A nuclear reactor for biological studies. A tank for biochemical reaction. Organisms reacting stimulus. Organism reacting stimulus. So among these, which one is the correct? The correct one is a device in which substance are treated to stimulate biochemical transformation by the living cell, means in the bioreactor. This is the bioreactor. In this one, what happens? The microorganism, living cells, will be multiplied, amplified, increased in the number. That will multiplied and increase in the number. As the increase in the number, the biochemical transformation will be takes place. Means the product will be produced. The product will be produced. That is the condition. Okay. The fermenter means, that is first statement is correct. The next one is, during isolation of DNA, addition of which of the following cause precipitation of purified DNA? Okay, so here in the suspension of the cell, so it consists the macromolecules. It consists the macromolecules. So these macromolecules will be removed one by one. Okay, first the RNA will be removed by using the enzyme. RNA polymerase enzyme. RNA polymerase enzyme will be used to remove the macromolecules. The next, protein will be removed. Protease enzyme. Carbohydrate, that will be removed by amylase. Okay, lipids will be removed by lipase. Okay, here at the beginning, what happens? All the macromolecules will be removed. Even though this DNA, this is the DNA. So this DNA will consist what? The sum of the histone proteins. These histone proteins are also be removed by the enzyme protease. This histone protein will also be removed by the histone protein. Okay, as it is completely removed all the macromolecules, to this one, what happens? They will add the what? The chemical that is called as chilled ethanol. it will add chilled ethanol. As the chilled ethanol will be added, so from the suspension, what happens? The DNA will get precipitated and it will come above the suspension. And from above the suspension, this DNA will be isolated. From above the suspension, this DNA will be isolated. So here, for the precipitation of the DNA, pure DNA will be caused by adding the chilled ethanol. So this is the correct one. Okay. So this ribonuclease enzyme will kill the RNA. DNA polymerase, what happens? It will help in the replication. Protease for the digestion of the protein. All these are the statements will be there. The correct one is chilled ethanol. After the formation of the product in a bioreactors, it undergoes through separation and purification processes before a finished product is ready for marketing. This process are collectively referred as, okay, so that is called as downstream process. Okay, so after the formation of the product in a bioreactor, it undergoes through a separation and purification process before a finished product is ready for marketing. That process is called as what? Downstream process. Okay, so in this downstream process, what is it? Separation and purification will be takes place. In the downstream process, separation and purification will be takes place. So what about this upstream process? So during the upstream process, what happens? The synthesis of biomolecules. The synthesis of biomolecules will be takes place. Upstream process, the synthesis of biomolecules will take place, and that biomolecules will again undergoes the downstream process, means undergoes separation and purification. That is called as upstreaming, biomolecules synthesis. Okay, then elution. So what happens from the agarose gel? This is the agarose gel sheet. In this agarose gel sheet, what happens? The desired DNA will be there. So the cutting of this desired DNA, okay, so this desired DNA will be cut off separately. Okay, so this desired DNA will be cut off separately. Okay, so this removing of the desired DNA from the gel, agarose gel, that process is called as elution. Transformation means the transfer of the genetic material. Okay, so this is the condition. And the our correct answer is downstreaming process. The next one. Which one of the following option is correct? First, the proteins are encoded by the gene CRY1AC and CRY2AB, controls cotton boll worms. Proteins encoded by CRY1AB controls corn borer, both 1 and 2. Proteins encoded by CRY1AC and CRY1AB controls flies. Okay, so here The first statement is the proteins encoded by the genes CRY1AC and CRY2AB controls cotton boll worm. So this statement is correct. Okay. Then second one, proteins encoded by CRY1AB controls corn borer. This statement is also correct. Okay, both the statement is correct. Then the answer is both 1 and 2. Okay, so this will not control the flies. This statement is wrong. The correct answer is both 1 and 2. Next, a primitive toxin, denatured toxin, toxin produced by protozoa, inactive toxin. Okay, protoxin is a primitive toxin, denatured toxin, toxin produced by protozoa, inactive toxin. So this protoxin is a protein. Protoxin is a protein. This protein is present in the form of a crystal. Okay, the crystal form protein is called as inactive toxin. So this crystal protein will be enter into the midgut. It will becomes activated and it will kills the insect. It will get kills the insect. So the correct statement, correct answer is, what is that? Inactive protoxin. The next question. Consumption of which one of the following foods can prevent the kind of blindness associated with vitamin A deficiency? Consumption of which one of the following foods can prevent the kind of blindness associated with vitamin A deficiency? Okay, so from the vitamin A deficiency, what happens? Night blindness will be produced. To prevent the vitamin A deficiency, a person should have eat golden rice. The person should have eat golden rice. Okay, because this golden rice consists vitamin A. Okay, so this golden rice will consist the vitamin A. So that vitamin A will be produced from the precursor, that is beta carotene. So this beta carotene gene will be taken by the plant that is called as daffodil plant. Beta carotene gene will be taken by the plant in the daffodil plant. So because of this gene, beta carotene gene, vitamin A synthesis, the color of the rice is yellow. Because of this yellow color, it is called as golden rice. Because of this yellow color, it is called as golden rice. Okay, the next one. Flavors are, so this is a tomato. Okay, flavor serve is the tomato. So this tomato, what happens? It is having the shelf life. It is having the shelf life. Okay, so what is the shelf life means? It will delay the ripening. Delay the ripening of the fruit. That is tomato. Okay, it will delay the ripening of the fruit. Okay, and this is having the better nutrient quality. Nutrient quality. It is having the better nutrient quality. That is the flavors are tomato. It is also genetically modified plant. Next one is canola. So this canola is also genetically modified plant. It consists it from this one that oil is extracted. From this one, oil is extracted. The next BT brinjal, as you already know, this BT brinjal is having the resistance with insecticides and pesticides. It is having resistance with insecticides and pesticides. Okay, this brinjal consists the BTG. The correct answer is golden rice. The next question. All are the biotechnologically applications in order to increase the food production. All are the biotechnological application in order to increase the food production, except first one is apiculture, agrochemical based agriculture, organic farming, genetically engineered crop based agriculture. Okay, all these are the four areas are there. So in this one, this apiculture will not be applied the biotechnology, because it is a culture of fishing, or the cultivation of the fish, or the growing of the fish. In this one, the biotechnology will not be used. But remaining this one, what happens? The biotechnology will be used. Okay, here, this agrochemical based agriculture. So in this one, what happens? The food production takes place. Okay, by using the chemicals, as you know, that is called as fertilizers, chemical fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides. That is chemical fertilizers, insecticide, pesticide. Okay, by this one, the agrochemical is there. Organic manure means, organic farming means, that is also agriculture, where the decomposition of the organic product, decomposition of dead remains of organism. Okay, it will be there. So genetically means alteration of what gene will be takes place. So in these three processes, we can improve or increase the food production. In this one, what happens? The food production will be takes place. This is concerned with agriculture. So this is concerned with apiculture, concerned with fish rearing or the fishy culture. The correct one is first one. The next, agrochemical based agriculture includes, use of fertilizers and pesticides, genetically modified crops, RNA interference and all of these. Okay, so this is correct one, that is use of fertilizers, pesticides and insecticides. So this use is called as agrochemical based agriculture. So by this use of fertilizers and pesticides, the what happens, increase in the yield. Increase in the yield will be takes place. Okay, so but slowly what happens, fertility of the soil is decreases. Slowly what happens, the fertility of the soil will be decreases. Why it will be decreases means the microflora or microorganism which are present in the soil, so which are present in the soil will get killed. As the microorganism or the microflora will killed in the soil, the fertility of the soil will be decreases by using this one. Okay, so genetically modified crop means the plants or the organisms where the manipulation of the gene will be takes place. RNA interference means, so this is also one of the method where the disease control will be takes place by the RNA. The correct one is fertilizers and pesticides. Next, first genetically modified plant commercially released in the India. Okay, the first genetically modified commercially released in the India is BT cotton. Okay, BT cotton. So all these are also genetically modified, but this commercially released in the market, that is BT cotton. And in the vegetable, in the fruit, what happens, favor savor will be first released plant in the market. Okay, cotton in the India, flavor savor, this is the first genetically modified plant released into the market, because this plant is having shelf life, means it will delay the ripening of the fruit. It will delay the ripening of the fruit, and it is having the what? It is having the better nutrition value. It is having the better nutrition value. And this BT brinjal, it is also genetically modified plant. Okay, it is also released into the market. And already you know that golden rice. The correct one is BT cotton. Next, which of the following genes were introduced in cotton to protect from the cotton boll worms? Which of the following will be introduced into the cotton to protect from the boll worms? That is Cry1AC and Cry2AB. So this will be added to the cotton plant to protect from the cotton boll worms. So this NIF gene, this is called as nitrogen fixing gene. NIF gene is called as nitrogen fixing gene. The next one, in which of the following industrial areas biotechnology is applicable? In which of the following industrial areas biotechnology is applicable? It is applied in the healthcare, it is applied in the environment, it is applied in the agriculture. Means in all the field, in all the field, the biotechnology will be applied in the healthcare by producing the nutritional quality plants or the nutritional value product. Environment, so to reduce the what the environmental toxic by developing the microorganism to kill the what pollutants. Agriculture, as you already studied, BT cotton, BT brinjal, tomato and golden rice. So that all the case in all the area the biotechnology will be applied. The next one, due to what food supply has increased during Green Revolution? Due to what food supply has increased during Green Revolution? So during the Green Revolution, what is that? Use of agrochemical, that is agrochemical based agriculture, the chemical fertilizers and pesticides. Chemicals, fertilizers and pesticides will be used. Okay, by this one, at the beginning, 3 times the yield will be increased. 3 times the yield will be increased. The next one, full form of genetically GMO. Full form of GMO. GMO means genetically modified organism. That is genetically modified organism. This is the correct one. The next, which of the following is responsible for causing disease? Which of the following is responsible for causing disease in plants? Okay, in the plants it will cause the disease: virus, herbicide, pesticide, all the above. So the correct one is the virus. It is a disease causing organism. Okay, these are the medicine or the chemicals to kill the insect and pest and herbicides. Okay, the correct one is virus. The correct one is the virus. The next one, genetically modified organisms are used for, genetically modified organisms are used for reducing reliance on chemical fertilizers. Reducing reliance on chemical fertilizers. So this is also correct. Developing pest resistant plant, it is also correct. Increasing efficiency of mineral usage. Increasing mineral efficiency of mineral usage by the plants that prevent early exhaustion of fertility of the soil. So this is also correct. Then the correct answer is all of these. The correct answer is all of these. The next one is, BT cotton genes repel bacterial pathogen, fungal pathogen, nematode parasite, insect pest. So for which the BT gene or cotton will be inserted to control the insect and pest disease to the cotton plant? The next, transgenic plants are plants having, transgenic plants are the plants are having what genes of other organism? It is having the genes of other organism. Means, so the isolated gene or desired gene will be inserted in this organism, that is called as transgenic plant, as you know that BT cotton, in this one BT gene. So this gene will be taken from the Bacillus thuringiensis, will be inserted into the cotton plant. Okay, so this cotton is called as genes of other organism. This is called as genetically or transgenic plants, which consists the genes of other organism. The next, this is not a genetically modified organism. This is not a genetically modified organism, that is Dolly. Dolly is the correct one. The next, main objective of production of or use of herbicide resistant genetically modified crop is, the main objective of production or use of herbicide resistance GM crop is to, first, encourage eco-friendly herbicide, reduce herbicide accumulation in the food articles for healthy safety, eliminate weeds from the field without the use of manual labor. Okay, eliminate the weeds from the field without the use of herbicide. Okay, so what is that? The use of herbicide to remove the weeds from the field without use of labor. Without the use of labor, what weeds will be removed. Next, genetically modified brinjal in India has been developed for what purpose? Insect resistance. The next one, which one of the following statement is correct? BT cotton indicates that it is genetically modified organism produced through biotechnology. Okay, so this BT will be produced through what? Genetic engineering. Okay, then somatic hybridization involves fusion of two complete plant cells carrying desired genes. This is the tissue culture. The anticoagulant hirudin is being produced from the transgenic brassica napus seeds. Okay, so this is the correct one. Flavor saver variety of tomato has enhanced the production of ethylene. So this is the wrong. The correct one is the third one. Okay, thank you.